All right, welcome back again to MBAbullshit.com. So the topic for this video is bond valuation for a coupon bond. Okay? Remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Now, before this video, make sure you have already watched my other free video on bond valuation, usual confusion, or else you will get very confused here, believe me. Okay, you should also already understand future value, present value, net present value, and internal rate of return. Okay, so you can watch my other free videos on these topics first, if you wish. Let's go back. Okay, so now let's go back to our example in the earlier video on usual confusion. So ABC Company issued a 3-year bond with a $1,000 face value and a 5% coupon rate, with coupons being paid once a year at the end of every year. It is now the beginning of its second year and the first coupon has already been paid. Bonds are now giving 4% interest for deposits. Okay, the bond's market value, okay, is $913. What is the bond's coupon payment? Well, it's very simple. The coupon payment is the face value, $1,000, times the coupon rate of 5%, and that equals $50. All right? So simple as that. But notice that for the face value, for the coupon payment, in computing the coupon payment, we use the face value. We did not use the market value of $913. And we also used the coupon rate of 5%. Okay? We did not use the 4% discount rate or interest rate for deposits. Okay? So remember that when we're computing the coupon rate. Now, given the same information, what is the bond's yield? Okay? Or yield to maturity. Remember, yield is the same as yield to maturity. Okay? It is not the same as current yield, which we already learned in the last video on usual confusion. Well, for this we use the IRR formula. Okay? Zero. We equate everything to zero, okay, and we equate everything to zero, and that means that over here we write the $913 that we actually paid for the bond, okay, and it is negative 913 because you're paying it, and then we have here the coupon payments that you get for the last 2 years of the bond. Okay, because remember, it is now beginning in its second year, so you have 2 more years that the bond will be alive, so you only get paid twice, 1, 2, instead of 3 times, even if it's a 3-year bond. Why? Because now you're buying it at the beginning of its second year. Alright, and we include, the $1,000, okay, that you will get back in the end when the bond matures. We call it the bond maturity, okay, when the bond is finished, when the life is over, you get back the entire $1,000 face value, even if you only paid $913 as the market value in the beginning of the second year. Alright? And if we do this, we now have to find the letter R. Oh yeah, and take note, we have to write the exponents over here. Okay, where do we get these exponents? You're paying this $913 today, so the exponent is 0 or negative 0. It doesn't matter. And the exponent here is negative 1. Why is it negative 1? Because this happens 1 year later. Okay? So you have to bring it back by 1 year. This happens 2 years later from today. So you have negative 2 over there. And if we use this formula to find R, okay, we have to guess what R might be such that this whole thing will equal exactly zero. Okay, we continue guessing until we find R, and in the end we will find that R is 10%. Okay, so now we know that R is 10% is, or R is 0.10 or 10%. So now we can say that the yield is 10%, or the yield to maturity is 10%. Now notice that notice what we did not use and what we did use. In the amount we paid over here, notice that we used the market value of $913, and we did not use the $1,000 face value. Okay? So remember that when you were computing the yield. You use the value that you actually paid for, or you look at the bond market value, because that's the amount you actually really paid to buy the bond. Okay? We did not use the bond face value in computing the yield using the IRR formula. Alright? So, next. Alright, next. How do we compute the bond's fair value? Alright? So here we have pretty much the same information as the last slide. The only difference is that we already know the yield, which is 10%, or the yield to maturity, which is 10%. Okay? So what is the bond's fair value now? Well, for this we use the net present value formula, and it looks like this. Okay? So the bond's fair value will equal the remaining coupon payments that you are entitled to receive, which is $50 1 year from now, another $50 2 years from now, and the remaining $1,000 face value, which you will get back 2 years from now as well. Okay? And notice that we will discount it. Okay? We will discount it using the net present value at the 4%, as we see here, which is the same as the 4% interest rate that banks outside are giving you. Okay? So if we do this formula over here, if we compute this formula over here, we will find that the bond fair value is $1,018.86. Alright, so what does this mean? This means that the bond market value, okay, the actual price that the bond is being sold in the market, which is $913, is a bargain. Okay, why is it a bargain? Well, it's being sold for only $913, but the actual fair value is $1,018. Alright? So, that means it's a bargain. Now remember, do not confuse this bond fair value with the bond's face value and the bond's market value. Alright?